Hello friends, today we are going to study cross elasticity of demand in detail. Let us start with meaning. In economics, the cross elasticity of demand or cross price elasticity of demand measures the percentage change of the quantity demanded for a good to the percentage change in the price of another good. In real life, the quantity demanded of good is dependent on not only its own price elasticity of demand, but also the price of other related products. The concept is used to identify the relationship between two goods. They can be complements, substitutes, or unrelated goods. There are three types of cross elasticity of demand covered in my video: negative cross price elasticity, positive cross price elasticity, and unrelated cross price elasticity. Negative cross price elasticity, where complementary cross elasticity of demand is less than zero. A negative cross elasticity denotes two products that are complements. If products A and B are complements, an increase in the price of B leads to a decrease in the quantity demanded for A, as A is used in conjunction with B. For example, in response to a 10% increase in the price of printer's ink, the demand for printer would be decreased by 20%. So, the cross elasticity of demand would be minus 20% divided by 10%, which is equal to minus 2, which means an increase in the price of ink will decrease the demand for printer. So, printer and ink are complement. As we can see from the graph above, there are two types of complementary goods: weak complementary and strong complementary. In the first instance, weak complementary goods cover those which rely on each other to be sold, rather than compete against each other. By contrast, strong complementary goods are two products that are largely used together. For instance, iPhones and iPhone cases. As consumers buy fewer iPhones, fewer cases will also be sold. Weak complementary goods are therefore two goods that are used with each other, but not on a frequent basis. For example, pancakes and maple syrup. Other sauces and toppings are used instead, which means the relationship isn't so strong. Second, positive cross price elasticity, where substitute cross elasticity of demand is more than zero. A positive cross elasticity denotes two products are substitutes. If products A and B are substitutes, an increase in the price of B leads to increase in the quantity demanded for A, as A is used in alternate with B. For example, if the price of coffee increases, the quantity demanded for tea, a substitute beverage, increases as consumers switch to a less expensive yet substitutable alternative. This is reflected in the cross elasticity of the demand formula, as both the numerator, percentage change in the demand of tea, and denominator, the price of coffee, show positive increases. As we can see from the charts, there are two types of positive cross elasticity of demand. These can come under close substitutes and weak substitutes. Close substitutes are goods that have a strong relationship with each other. So, an increase in the price of one good strongly affects the demand of the other. For example, an increase in the price of Starbucks will lead to an increase in the demand for Costa coffee. By contrast, weak substitute goods still have a relationship between them, but it is not substantial. For example, ordinary tea and coffee in the supermarket are not widely exchanged for one another. However, they are substitute goods. Third, unrelated cross price elasticity, where unrelated cross elasticity of demand is equal to zero. Zero cross elasticity implies two goods are independent. A price change of good A is unrelated to demand change of good B. So changes in the price of product A have no effect on the demand for product B. For example, we can compare two random products, milk and iPhones. If the price of milk was to increase by 10%, it would have no impact on the number of iPhones sold. From this graph, we can see that an increase in price of car does not affect the demand of cloth. Thus, cross elasticity of demand is zero. So these are the total points covered in my video. Thanks for watching.